Just let you know, because your YDNA, I assume, is E. I don't know what it is.
No,
what is your Y marker?
R.
So if you're R, no, hold on. All right, cool. So now R, ladies and gentlemen, goes back to Europe, for the record.
No,
all right. But anyway, hold on.
When people talk about their DNA results, I keep hearing the word haplogroups. Joining me today is Dr. Samantha Esselman, a scientist from the 23andMe ancestry team who can unpack this concept. So, Samantha, what are haplogroups? Truly, it sounds like a word my dad would make up in Scrabble.
Well, it's definitely a real word. The first kind is paternal haplogroups, traced through Y chromosomes, which get passed exclusively from fathers to sons. And actually, the beginning of the word haplogroup, haplo, comes from the Greek word aplos, which means simple.
Oh, well, that's a good memory jogger.
Yeah. I have an analogy.
Okay.
So imagine a guy thousands of years ago. And this guy has a special recipe for his, award-winning paleo soup.
Oh, okay.
And then he, along with his brothers, inherited this recipe from his dad, who got it from his dad. And all the men in the family faithfully stick to this recipe, no changes. And then these can help you understand where you fit into this ancient family tree of all humans.
Wow, I feel like the world has got a whole lot smaller.
And let me also tell you something about your DNA. Your DNA that you showed, the last one that you showed, is not that you're from Sudan. That's the time period that the Sudan genetics got mixed into your DNA, because we're showing it all summer. All right, just to let you know, because your Y DNA, I assume, is E. I don't know what it is.
No,
what is your Y marker?
R.
What is your Y marker?
R.
So if you're R, no, hold on. All right, cool. So now, all ladies and gentlemen, go back to Europe for the record.
Welcome back to my channel, everyone, and thank you for joining me. This is the seventh video in my Origin series, which explores family history research and several of the haplogroups that exist in my paternal and maternal genetic groups. This group, plyogenetically, is classified as R1B1A1B. The haplogroup is of particular interest for the genetic history of Western Europe, being in the most common European haplogroup. Its prevalence in Poland is estimated at around 22.7%, compared to Wales at 92.3%. It is carried by approximately 110 million European men.
How important is this whole R marker conversation with Gorilla Heathen?
Oh my God. How important?
Oh man, listen to the video. Saying, but this is something that I never expected at the debate, Ngozi. I never expected him to come out and show and talk DNA. Obviously, he's not familiar with DNA, with his conversation. But I want people to take a look at what the brother said and draw their own conclusion, because it was pretty interesting. I'm gonna play his part first.
Right? Okay, cool. Well, that makes sense. So I'm looking at this, and of course, typically anybody black, when you send that DNA, what's gonna happen? They're gonna tell you, you're a little bit Nigerian, you're a little bit Ghanaian.
Anybody DNA R. The R marker does not come from Sudan. And anybody teach you that has lost your mind. Alizar, you have lost your mind tonight. The R marker. If you know African ancestry with Rick Kittles, the black guy, darker than me and Sarnetta, he owns African ancestry. He has the R marker, and it comes from Europe. Why does it come from Europe? Alizar, I don't think you should have told us your DNA results, buddy. Because you might definitely not be an Israelite. You just exposed yourself.
What is your Y marker?
R is a European marker.
Oh.
That's what King James had. He had RM269, which goes to the Caucasus Mountains. So if you show us your Y marker tonight, I'll definitely tell you if you're an Israelite or not. You just kill your whole entire self tonight.
It is believed the family have roots in Wales. Firstly, let's take a look at some of the ancient and prehistoric links that share this DNA haplogroup. There are 85 known samples recorded on the ancient DNA website, and they are all pretty much continental Europe or Russian. For anyone who shares this Y DNA, you're in for a treat.
You have something golden, kind of leaves some cynic ambient. It's gonna always give you a little bit of this, but here was the most interesting part to me. The oldest part of my DNA said Sudanese. Now, this let me kind of scratch my head for a second. How is the oldest part of my DNA?
Then you used the little 3 minutes. He was like, yeah, I'm just finna go in on this haplogroup, man. I don't even need this slab. I was like, oh, man.
Oh, man. This was...
It was death by DNA.
I gotta play that clip again right now, man. That clip is funny.
And let me also tell you something about your DNA. Your DNA that you showed, the last one that you showed, is not you're from Sudan. That's the time period that the Sudan genetics got mixed into your DNA, because we're showing all of them. All right, just to let you know, because your Y DNA, I assume, is E. I don't know what it is.
No, Sudanese.
No, what is your Y marker?
R. Sudanese.
So if you're R, no. Hold on. All right, cool. So now R, ladies and gentlemen, goes back to Europe for the record.
All right, but anyway, hold on.
You know, I'm just going to say his name, Gorilla Hebrew. Why, according to your perspective, he's not an Israelite. I'm going to explain that. So he said in the debate that his haplogroup was R. So the reason why this is significant is because haplogroup R is found all throughout Europe. So you have certain tribes in West and Central Africa that have high frequencies of R. What a lot of people don't know, including Gorilla Hebrew, is that you had a back migration of European pastoralists that, you know, migrated back into Africa, intermarried with Black African women. And this is why those Chadic tribes and Cameroonian tribes, specific tribes, have haplogroup R. Now, why is that significant? Because that haplogroup is European. The reason why that's significant is because Gorilla Hebrew is that haplogroup. By his
he's not the haplogroup, bro. He's British. He's M269.
Bro, he's British. He's M269.
Welcome back to my channel, everyone, and thank you for joining me. This is the seventh video in my The Y DNA haplogroup RM269 has also been found extensively through ancient samples discovered in Germany. These samples belong to the Belbeker culture. Some of the skeletons found and analyzed were from the village of Kromsdorf, Thuringia, Germany.
Sudanese. We're from West Africa. That's where the slave ship left from. Not the Sudan. Right? Next slide. Then I thought about this. The Akan migrated from the north. They went through Egypt and settled in Nubia, Sudan, around 5...
At the very beginning of the European Bronze Age, arising from around 2800 BC. In France, the haplogroup has been discovered in skeletons that belonged to the Latène culture. Latène was a European Iron Age culture. It developed and flourished during the late Iron Age, from about 450 BCE to the Roman conquest in the 1st century BCE. Interestingly, this DNA group is also associated with both Danish and Swedish Vikings.
Now it begins to make sense, because I know that the Akan were scattered all over the Caribbean, right? That would include Haiti. Now it makes sense as to why the oldest part of my DNA is Sudanese, because the Akan came from the Sudan to Ghana. Next slide. Now, but it says first they came.
There are lots of samples discovered from skeletal remains found in both Skara and Karda, Sweden, and Sealand, Denmark. The Viking Age, 793 to 1066 AD, was a period during the Middle Ages when Norsemen, known as Vikings, undertook large-scale raiding, colonizing, conquest, and trading throughout Europe, and even reaching North America. RM269 has also been associated with the Kovan culture and the East Slavs in Russia, which is interesting as a very famous Russian dynasty carries that haplogroup, the Romanov family. And from excavating and studying the remains of Nicholas II of Russia, who was murdered alongside all of his family in 1918.
And let me also tell you something about your DNA. Your DNA that you showed, the last one that you showed, is not that you're from Sudan. That's the time period that the Sudan genetics got mixed into your DNA, because we're showing it all summer. All right, just to let you know, because your Y DNA, I assume, is E. I don't know what it is.
No, it's E.
No, what is your Y marker?
R.
So if you're R, no, hold on. All right, cool. So now R, ladies and gentlemen, goes back to Europe.
It was discovered that he belonged to the subclade RM269. If no illegitimacy breaks exist in his tree paternally, Nicholas II descends from Elimar I, Count of Oldenburg, who was born in 1040 and died in 1112. Through the male Oldenburg lineage, we also find King Christian I of Denmark, born 1426 and died in 1481. His daughter, Margaret, went on to marry King James III of Scotland. Nicholas II, last Tsar of Russia, is not the only famous monarch to have had his genome tested. Three of the kings belonging to the history of Hanover have too. These include King George I, King George IV, and William IV. In my own lineage, I can trace my Harris line back to my 8th great-grandfather, Henry Harris of Ewhurst, Surrey. He was born in 1655 and died in 1707. From the Harris DNA project, it has been suggested that the Harris family may have originated in Wales, which is certainly very likely when you consider that 92.3% of Welsh men share their male Y DNA with that one subclade, RM269.
He's M269.
Which is certainly very likely when you consider that 92.3% of Welsh men share their male Y DNA with that one subclade, RM269.
He's M269.